This continuation of that grateful stricture which is in us to the men, the very jet of their pleasure, I owed, it seems, to a happy habit of body, juicy, plump, and furnished towards the texture of those parts, with a fullness of soft, springy flesh, that yielding sufficiently, as it does, to almost any distension, soon recovers itself so as to retighten that strict compression of its mantlings and folds, which form the sides of the passage, wherewith it so tenderly embraces and closely clips any foreign body introduced into it, such as my exploring finger then was. Finding then everything in due tone and order, I remembered my fears, only to make a jest of them to myself, and now, palpably mistress of nay sighs of man, and triumphing in my double achievement of pleasure and revenge, I abandoned myself entirely to the ideas of all the delight I had swam in. I lay stretching out, glowingly alive all over, and tossing with burning impatience for the renewal of joys that had sinned, but in a sweet excess. Now did I loose my longing, for about 10 in the morning, according to expectation, Will, my new humble sweetheart, came with a message from his master, Mr. H., to know how I did. I had taken care to send my maid on an errand into the city, that I was sure would take up time enough, and, from the people of the house, I had nothing to fear, as they were plain good sorts of folks, and wise enough to mind no more other people's business than they could well help. All dispositions then made, not forgetting that of lying in bed to receive him, when he was entered the door of my bedchamber, a latch that I governed by a wire, descended, and secured it. I could not but observe that my young minion was as much spruced out as could be expected from one in his condition, a desire of pleasing that could not be indifferent to me, since it proved that I pleased him, which, I assure you, was now a point I was not above having in view. His hair trimly dressed, clean linen, and above all, a hale, ruddy, wholesome country look, made him out as pretty a piece of women's meat as you could see, and I should have thought nay one much out of taste that could not have made a hearty meal of such a morsel as nature seemed to have designed for the highest diet of pleasure.